Legislative Resolution Number 246 by Senator Marchione, mourning the tragic and untimely death of New York State Trooper Timothy P. Pratt on October 26, 2016.
Senator Marchione.
Thank you, Mr. President. I rise to speak on my resolution honoring the life and legacy of New York State Trooper Timothy Pratt. Trooper Timothy Pratt's life and legacy stand as testaments to his courage, selflessness, honor, decency, and steadfast commitment to protecting, serving, and helping others. Trooper Pratt saved lives, he touched lives, and inspired lives. He was a life of purpose, principle, and character, one that truly made a positive difference. If you look up the definition of public servant, there should be a picture of New York State Trooper Timothy Pratt right beside it. Trooper Pratt faithfully and dutifully served our nation, our state, his family, and the South Glens Falls community that he loved so dearly. He was a 1979 graduate of South Glens Falls High School. Following graduation, he joined the United States Air Force and faithfully served our country for 7 years before being honorably discharged in 1986. Timothy Pratt began his lifelong career as a trooper with the New York State Police on March 30, 1987. The duration of his well-regarded career was spent patrolling in Troop G, based out of the Wilton Barracks. He was assigned to the Traffic Incident Management Detail and was a proud member of the Elite State Police Motorcycle Unit, where he led the 9/11 Memorial Motorcycle Ride from Albany to New York City. Trooper Pratt was a role model, friend, and inspiration to his fellow law enforcement officers. Trooper Pratt was a member of the American Legion Post 574 and participated in many volunteer events and charitable causes. Among his volunteer work was the annual South Glens Falls Marathon Dance as an alumni and as a member of the school's first marathon dance. This year's dance raised $823,614.91 and was in honor of Trooper Pratt. To the lives he saved and touched, to those he inspired, Trooper Pratt was known as the go-to guy. He was the one to call first when in a pinch or in need of a helping hand, because everyone knew, no matter what, he would always be there. He was the proud father of three loving children, Shane, James, and Sarah, as well as his grandchildren, baby girls Tagon, Icorn, and Charlie Pratt, his beloved fiance Sue Clark and her two children, Taylor and Hannah. In addition to his children, grandchildren, fiance, and her children, he is survived by his siblings, Michael Pratt, Kathleen Bourdreau, Maureen Leggett, Lori LaFountain, Mary LeBlair, brother-in-law Paul Flood, the Godden family, and many nieces and nephews. And with us here in Senate today, in the Senate chambers today, are his children, Sarah, James, and Shane, his fiance Sue and her sister Lori, and his sister Lori, New York State Police Captain Bob Patnaud, Acting Troop G Commander, New York State Police Captain John W. McCarthy, Jr., Chuck Salloway, Station Commander at Clifton Park Station, Saratoga in the gallery, Saratoga County Sheriff Michael Zerlo, Warren County Sheriff Bud York, Sharon Shira, who has the permit, two troopers' mom, a proud mother of two troopers, and also Tom Mithin, a historian from Half Moon, who wanted to be here. My husband, who has never come to session, wanted to make sure that he was here today to honor Trooper Pratt. In addition, we have the members of the many members of the New York State Police and the New York State Police Honor Guard, which were also part of his family. We owe a debt of gratitude to Trooper Pratt and all the courageous men and women of law enforcement. They are, all of you are, devoted public servants who risk your lives to protect and serve. It is difficult, demanding, and dangerous work that we civilians can scarcely comprehend. You deserve our thanks and our praise. To quote scripture, blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Public servants like Trooper Timothy Pratt, they are peacekeepers and peacemakers, children of God and pillars of their communities. Trooper Pratt was all of these things and a faithful, honorable, devoted public servant, a loving grandfather, father, brother, uncle, son, fiance, friend, and role model, who made the ultimate sacrifice in the line of duty serving the residents of New York. Trooper Pratt is a true hero among heroes. New York State mourns the loss of this great man, this devoted public servant, one of New York's finest. We honor his life and his legacy of service, and we will forever remember New York State Trooper Timothy Pratt. I want to again thank the members of Trooper Pratt's family who joined us today, as well as the members of the New York State Police and all law enforcement, and to the New York State Police Honor Guard, thank you. Thank you, Mr. President.
Senator Galvin.
Thank you, Mr. President. I too rise to honor Trooper Timothy Pratt today and welcome his family. Thank my colleague, Senator Marchione, for bringing this resolution forward. Very appropriate that we honor one of New York's finest in what is the State Police's 100th year. I had a chance to talk with some of our guests today, and I was very, very proud when I was able to tell them that I served in the New York State Police. What I didn't tell you was that my brother is still with the State Police, who served with Tim. And while my career overlapped, my service overlapped with Tim's, I had not ever met him, but I know that my brother did. I have an uncle who served in the State Police. My father served in the State Police. And I mention that because it has been part of my life for as long as I can remember, and part of my family's life. And you have heard, I know you've experienced, because you're part of it, the State Police family. And I feel that very much, and of course, by extension, the law enforcement family, and you see the support that is here today. I also had occasion a number of years ago, I was George Beach's roommate for a period of time at the Academy. And the new superintendent had just recently taken office, and it was shortly after that Tim gave his life in service to the state. And I called the superintendent, and what he said to me simply is that he was out there grinding it out every day, still doing it after 29 years, and in the superintendent's words, one of the good guys, which very simple words, but I can't think of a better compliment. And clearly, from what I have learned about Trooper Pratt, so well deserved. We were reminiscing a little earlier. I recognized the gray hair of Captain McCarthy, and I have some here. And I had occasion to be at the Academy last night, and I was looking on the walls of all the troopers that had graduated, and thinking to myself, there's not many people left on the job that I worked with and remember. So John, I'm happy to see you here today as well. And finally, while I was at the Academy, I had occasion to go and spend a few minutes where the memorial is, the Wall of Honor inside. And of course, Tim's photo is up there in honor with the other 139 members that gave their lives over the past 100 years serving our great state's citizens. And I took the time to read the page that's dedicated to him. And I just simply want to say to you, thank you so much. You must be very, very proud. While it's so sad and such a tragedy, we are thrilled to have you here today to honor Tim. And I want to repeat it one more time, to honor one of New York State's finest in the 100th year of the New York State Police. Thank you, Mr. President.
Very nice. Senator Little.
Thank you, Mr. President, and thank you, Senator Marchione, for this resolution, and to all of our state troopers who are here today, and to the family who has come down today. I've known the family for a long time, members of them, and just want to express my sincere sympathy about your loss. We often hear the term that someone says, oh, that person was larger than life. Trooper Tim Pratt was larger than life. He made a significant difference in everyone around him's life. He contributed to the community. While he lived in South Glens Falls, his community was much, much wider than South Glens Falls. He was one person who just spent most of his time helping other people and actually died helping someone, a truck driver, who was lost. You can't say enough about all of his contributions and just seeing the thousands and thousands of people who have mourned him and the dance marathon where they raised all that money, almost $1 million in his honor, is just unbelievable, but not really when you think of who it was being done for. So as much as we wish his life had been longer and not lost, we know that he lived a life that was very, very well lived, a life that you can be very, very proud of, and that we can all look to see how to better ourselves and live our lives better. My love and prayers and thoughts are with you.
Senator Akshar.
Thank you, Mr. President. Senator Marchione, thank you. Incredibly important that we're doing this today. You know, I would respectfully offer that there is no more noble a profession than being a member of law enforcement. I'm a little partial because I'm a former member. You know, I think when we lose a dedicated public servant in the line of duty, it cuts to the very core of all New Yorkers, regardless of your political persuasion. So on behalf of the people of this great state, to the family, I say thank you. Thank you for sharing your loved one with us. We are incredibly honored, and I offer my deepest condolences and sympathies to all of you. And I pray that God continues to place his mighty, powerful hand on each of you and brings you some peace. Mr. President, thank you.
To Trooper Tim Pratt's family, thank you. We're honored to have you here today. Honored that you're joining us. And on behalf of the New York State Senate, on behalf of a very grateful state, and a very grateful body, we would like to extend our gratitude for his life, for your sacrifice, and for the great service that Tim Pratt's life had for this state. We'd like to recognize his life and his service in our way in this chamber by recognizing him now as a body. So I'd ask the body to rise and to recognize the life and service of Trooper Tim Pratt.